Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemia is a condition in which there are not enough red blood cells in the blood due to the premature destruction of the red blood cells. There are a number of different specific types of hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemia occurs when the bone marrow is unable to increase the production to make up for the premature destruction of the red blood cells. If the bone marrow is able to keep up with the early destruction, anemia does not occur. This is sometimes called compensated hemolysis. There are many types of hemolytic anemia, which are classified by the reason for the premature destruction of the red blood cells. The defect may be in the red blood cells itself, an intrinsic factor, or outside the red blood cells, an extrinsic factor. Intrinsic factors are often present at birth or are hereditary. Abnormalities in the proteins that build the normal red blood cells or differences in the protein inside the red blood cell that carries oxygen or hemoglobin. Extrinsic factors include abnormal immune system responses, blood clots in small blood vessels, certain infections, and side effects of medications. This slide summarizes the types of hemolytic anemia. Please feel free to pause this video to read it over. Symptoms of hemolytic anemia are essentially the symptoms of anemia. It includes chills, dark urine, enlarged spleen, fatigue, fever, pale skin color, rapid heart rate, shortness of breath, and jaundice, which is a yellow discoloration of the skin. Tests that can be done in people with suspected hemolytic anemia include absolute reticulocyte count, free hemoglobin in serum and urine, red blood cell count, hemoglobin, hematocrit, LDH levels, etc. Treatment depends on the type and cause of the hemolytic anemia. Folic acid, iron replacement, and corticosteroids may be used. In emergencies, a blood transfusion or removal of the spleen, a splenectomy, might be necessary. Depending on the underlying cause of the hemolytic anemia, the condition might recur. Therefore, close monitoring and making sure all differential diagnoses are considered, you must follow up with your primary care doctor and possibly a hematologist, a specialist in blood disorders. Significant fatigue, shortness of breath, lightheadedness, passing out, any other significant symptom or progression of existing symptoms, you must return to the emergency department. For more videos like this one, please go to edexitvideo.com. But remember, these are educational videos and should never replace the care or attention of a medical professional. Please take a moment to like my video and to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.